Hekawatua rima, hekawatua ono, hekawatua fitu, hekawatua waru, hekawatua iwa, hekawatua ngahuru. Takina hekawa hekawa na tanoroa ka pipi ka wawai, ka ohaya, ka whana koe raro I runga te ara. Tutuki te rangi eke, eke, eke tangaroa.
Tūtapa, tūtapa, tūtapa mai, kaua ko te kaua nui, ko te kaua roa, ko te kaua kāru, mā hei tuki mai te pau kā o ki te āni wenua. Ruruku tia ki te toi, nuku ruruku tia ki te toi, rangi hā, mō hā, kā ruruku taku rama, ko te rama nā wai, ko te rama nā tū. Kā ruruki hea, kā ruruki wai o riki, kā ruruki wai o raka. Ka pē ti, ka pē tā, ka pē māhu ki te marangai tū wai, au akia eke, eke panuku, eke tangaroa, whanu, whanu, haramai te toki. Haumi e, hui e,
tai ki e.
Birmingham is a civic university, a university of and for the people of Birmingham. It's a university which seeks to be actively engaged with the communities around it, with the students in its care, and with its graduates who can be found in all parts of the world. The building we are in today is a very fitting place to hold this ceremony. The Great Hall, which is down below us, a century ago was the home of the Southern Cross Hospital, and some 17,000 soldiers passed through the building during the 5 years of the Great War. Not all of them survived their injuries. There is also in the entrance to the building a roll of honour to those members of staff of the University of Birmingham who died in the conflict. This was our way of honouring the dead. We are gathered here today to honour the Maori ancestors in the most fitting way we can. The university is proud of its history and its cultural collections. Will you recognise that the Maori remains are best held by the Te Papa Repatriation Centre, so they can be returned to their homeland? We're delighted to be able to pass the ancestors into the safekeeping of the Te Papa Repatriation Centre and wish them well for the work ahead of them. Thank you.
Well, I'm Eric Jenkinson, Pro Vice Chancellor and Head of the College of Medical and Dental Sciences. As you will know, the College has held the Maori collection for a number of years. In fact, for such a number of years that, unfortunately, accurate records no longer remain. But what I can assure you of is that in the time that we have held the ancestors, we have treated them with great respect. They have not been as part of any display or indeed used for teaching. So we hope we have accorded them the respect to which they are entitled and due. And it is a great pleasure and a privilege for us now to be able to hand them on to complete their journey to the homeland. Thank you.
I'm Dr. June Jones, I'm the College Lead on Religious and Cultural Diversity. I'm delighted that we can come together to honour the ancestors today. It's been a privilege to work with our colleagues at the Repatriation Programme for the last 2.5 years. Our very first discussions were about how we could take the ancestors home, and it's so wonderful that we're able to begin that process today. Today is a day of mixed emotions for many of us. I'm so pleased that we're able to return the ancestors home, and I'm so pleased that we are able to honour them today. But I'm also sad. I'm sad that they were taken from their home place in the first place. I'm sad that their families were dishonoured. And I'm sad that there's still a need for your work. Learning about our shared history is so important, and being truthful about the reality of that history is vital. There are so many practices that were commonplace in times gone by that we're now deeply ashamed of. The practice of taking Maori heads and remains is one of those practices that we're deeply ashamed of. There is talk about different cultures and different times and different norms. But there are many explanations for what happened to the ancestors, but no justification. It's a shame that we don't know more about the ancestors. We don't know their names. We don't know precisely where they lived. We don't know what happened to them. But we do know that they would want to return to their own soil. New Zealand and the United Kingdom have so much in common. We each enjoy going to each other's countries for holidays. Many of our graduates aspire to work in each other's countries. We admire each other's landscapes. We share many memorable sporting moments, most commonly when you thrash us at rugby. And we enjoy each other's foods. But there's something that we don't share in common, and that's the degree of knowledge about what happens to ancestors. In New Zealand, Maori people know that this practice In the UK, it's just never talked about. People don't know it happened. But when they learn about it, they're so shocked and they are ashamed. During the repatriation seminar yesterday evening, attended by so many students and staff and members of the public, there was a genuine emotion in the room as you shared firsthand what happened to the ancestors and how they came to arrive in the UK. Your honesty and your careful preparation of the facts was greatly appreciated. We then went down to Bramah Music Hall and we enjoyed your music demonstrations. We listened with our ears, but we listened with our hearts as well, and you called to places deep within us. I realised that returning the ancestors to the Repatriation Centre is only the start of their final journey, you have much work to undertake, and we're sorry that our lack of records make your work even harder. I wish you every success where you try and understand where the ancestors originated from and where would be most appropriate to bury them. I wish you all a safe and prosperous journey back home, and I pray that you will find soil for the ancestors, and that the final act of honouring them will be to return them to their final resting place.
What we would like to do at this stage is we say tuku, tuku aroha, and literally that means give our appreciation or give our love. So the gift for us is really having our ancestors return. It's quite important for Māori communities to receive their ancestors. They are temporary. Hopefully they will only spend a short time at Tepa. But our ultimate goal is for them to return back to their communities of origin. I just want to indicate one of our traditional sayings from back home. Tukuna mai he kapunga onione hei tangi. There was a warrior that was captured, and he was kept in an area isolated from his homeland. And as an elder, he knew that his time of passing was close. So he said the same. And what it means in English is, give me a handful of soil from my homeland so I may feel the warmth of my ancestors and cry. And so what we would like the ancestors to appreciate is that they probably were saying the same thing over the last 100 to 200 years. But now they will be able to be in their homeland and they will feel the spirit and the life force that comes from the homeland. And that's what we appreciate, is that we do not have the privilege of changing the past, but we have the privilege of reconciling the past now as contemporary peoples. And that is what the Birmingham University has allowed us to do, to reconcile our past. So thank you very much. And in recognition of that, we would like to offer a gift to Professor Ia Rovner. One is a book, and one is a piece of greenstone. Greenstone in our country, in our culture, is very important. It is significant. It is significant because another saying we have, or word we have, is tato ponamu. And tato ponamu means greenstone door. And greenstone is a symbol of our peace, and the door allows us to enter into peace. So it is something that you wear around your neck, and so we would like to offer that to you as a process of reconciling your past. And the book is one of the books that Arapata edited, and so it's a very significant book for us, and we'd like to offer that to you.
for Professor Eric Jenkinson. We would like to offer the same piece of green stone as a symbol of peace, and also a book for no moko, which is about our tattooing from our tattooing tradition. So one of the ancestors here is a mummified head, so he wears the tattoos, our traditional tattoos. So this book will explain a bit more about our tattooing process, our history and our culture. So we would like to offer it. There are many privileges of being a man in our country and a tradition in our traditional culture. The man was very important, but there are many privileges of being a woman. In respect to our greenstone, a woman can wear earrings. So we have two pieces for you. We not only have the pendant, but we have greenstone earrings, which are cool. We are reclaiming our musical instruments and our musical style, traditional music, so we would like to offer that book to you, and also our greenstone earrings, and also a greenstone pendant.
Thank you so much.
The other thing we would like to complete this process is we have a word called Te Hei Mai Rua, which is literally means the breath of life. So we would like to exchange our breath of life, and we do that by pressing our noses. So we would like. We will do that after you present your notes.
Into a bowl. This ash tree fell locally, and one of our local artists has turned it into a bowl for you.
As the kaihautu Māori co-leader of the National Museum of New Zealand, Te Papa Tongarewa, it's truly my privilege to stand here and to thank you, Birmingham University, Professor Ian Crosvenor, Eric Kent Jenkinson, and Dr. June Jones. Our hearts go out to this university. And I say that because the repatriation, it's a journey, and as Te Hiri Kiakia said, a journey of reconciliation and healing. We've been on this journey since 2003, and in fact before 2003, trying to locate and find our ancestors scattered in museums throughout the world. Their histories have been entwined with New Zealand's history of colonisation, Western imperialism, the pursuit of scientific endeavour, museology, all those things which scattered our ancestors, took them away from home. I thank the Birmingham University because in 2011, you came to us, you approached us and said that we have your ancestors at this university and would like to return them home. To us, Mai te mako, from our hearts, we want to thank you for that, for your whakao. Not all museums are like that, not all universities are like that. Relationships are the key to the repatriation program. And it is a journey. With Te Hede Kiaki and the team, the last 10 years we've been approaching museums, medical colleges, universities, creating relationships with them, with the hope that through the understanding and the significance that we have for our ancestors, that hopefully they can be, they can have an open heart and have them returned home. I couldn't imagine a better place to do that, remembering those who fell in the two wars, the Great War, First World War, Second World War, our people fought alongside, and what did we fight for? We fight for our freedom, for our land, and our people also fought for their land and for their sovereignty. So I just want to, on behalf of the National Museum, our chief executive and our staff, and our repatriation, it's quite a spiritual journey. At the end of this month, we have a number of other museums to journey to and to greet our ancestors and prepare them for their journey home. At the end of this month, they'll be welcomed with the utmost love and recognition and respect by a large representation of Māori leaders at the National Museum of New Zealand on our marae. They'll be spoken to as if still alive yesterday. They'll be wept over, lamented, and they'll be recalled. And their spirits, and as Te Hede Kiaki said, the life principle and their motive will be acknowledged, and that means a lot to us. Our ancestors are very much part of our present world and who we are. We're not here. We're here, but we're here because of our ancestors and that continuous line of genealogy or whakapapa. So on behalf of these many people, Dr. June Jones, thank you very much. Ngā mihi ki ake. Thank you for you and your staff and the university for taking care of our ancestors. And I think what you said there, we really appreciate that. It is a sad journey when we visit and encounter and our ancestors in all continents of the world, medical colleges and so forth, but it's really reassuring that they've been well cared for. So I just want to acknowledge that, your staff and your university for taking care of them. They've been cloaked now in preparation for their journey home, and the karakia and the incantations that our elders provide have cleared the way. So on behalf of, I know I stand here on behalf of all the Māori people, the tribes, and if they were here, they would say the same thing. Kia ora. They would be saying, arapata, make sure we thank them. Make sure we thank them from our hearts for allowing us to take our ancestors home. So, ngā mihi mai te mākau, kei runga kei raro, tēnei te mihi atu, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou.
E tua, atura, te upori atu, o te iwi Māori, e tūnei, e mi kawana Māori.
reira e hika mā, kei ngā mana, kei ngā mana mei, kei ngā reo, tēnei tīngā tiki a koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou.
Our next step is we're going to come now, Aldo will do the last incantation for the ancestors.
Te tamata wairua tapu, rire, pau. Ue, 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 waire, waire, ute, waire, tai, waire, te ono tapu. Ahura, tangata, kutu meturaki atuki, tangata atai. Ahura, tangata atai, meturaki atuki, tangata uta. Mero hokira, i te kore, piru, i te kore, piru, i te wahi, o i te tuetue, o. Kamata mai te ara, kamata mai te ara. Kawarakata mai te tukata tamai o hori tāho kwa hekutama ki ngono ki te atahetau nira mai e. Mai e, mai e te tipua, mai e, mai e te tapitu. Haru mai koe he, haru mai koe tu, 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 haru mai koe tu. He tāne kai hiya, pāno, pāno, haru mai te tōki, haumi e, hui e.
Aye.